He said, really? He said, I'm coming to see you right now. And as soon as the man took up his dress and dressed up, another brother called her and said, sister, are you at home? He said, yes, I'm at home. Are you busy? He said, no, I'm not busy. Are you expecting anybody? He said, no, I'm not expecting anybody. Ah, the devil that wants to frustrate the destiny of this lady. She said, no, I'm not expecting. He said, I have a gift for you. And he said, what is the gift? He said, wait, when I bring it, you will love it. And she said, oh, I can't wait for the gift too. Because they used to greet and greet, and you see, they are wonderful friends. But the brother meant no good for her. Are you listening to me? He meant no good for her. The demon that wants to frustrate the blessing of this lady maybe has whispered to him, the blessing of this girl is coming today. Go and block it. And he went to the gate of this girl and knocked, and the girl opened the door. And as they were talking and they were talking, as she was unwrapping the gift, this brother that want to propose with the wedding ring just opened the door. And open, I saw them talking. They were just talking, oh, and the brother closed the door and went back. He said, because I called her a while ago, and she said she was not, she was alone. If she can lie to me, she can be a good wife. The devil, look at how the devil blocked a miracle. And the brother left. And when this brother that brought the gift eventually left, she called us. Yeah, I was telling you to come inside. He just came to greet me. We are just neighbor. We are friends. He just called me after you called me. She started explaining. The brother said, that explanation is on the day of miracle. There are people. They've been hanging around you. When something good wants to happen, that's when they come and call you out. That's the day they will give you an appointment that will block your blessing. That's the day they will tell you, sister, I want to go shopping. Can we take a ride together? And then, unknown to you, there's somebody that God is arranging to meet you. And they took you out of your place of appointment.
Yes, sir.
And only for you to discover later that they actually came for you. But you're not on ground. On the day of your glory, on the day of your appointment, enemies that want to keep you sitting on your game, may they not come to you.
Amen.
May they miss their own road to your house.
Amen.
I said they will miss their road to your house.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Have you ever missed your way to your house before?
Yes, I am.
Eh? Yes. To your own house. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
You don't know this life. Your own house.
You miss your house.
Ah.
Ah,
you don't. You be past your own house. You say, ah, you even know when I pass. Your own house. Talk less of enemy. I say, oh, the enemy that want to keep you on your gate, that doesn't want you to cross to the left, may they miss the gate of your house.
Amen.
There are people that God wants to separate from us, so that he can undo us, he can take care of us.
Yes.
So that he can peter us, so that he can join our life. Mm-hmm. Peter was sent to pamper this man. John was sent to join this man to destiny. There are people that God has positioned over destiny, that they are on their way. Every other person has passed us, mm-hmm, but they are coming late. But their lateness is for a purpose.
Yes.
So that by the time they finish helping you up, everybody that passed you before, they will be the one that will celebrate you.
Yes.
By the time the man entered the temple, they were already in the temple. And when they came in with Peter, with the man of God, are you hearing me?
Yes.
When they came in with the man of God, I remember I went to a conference one day, and I was presidentially invited to. I sat down gently in my own house, and they brought me invitation and said, there's a big gathering of men of God, and we want you to be in that conference. In fact, you have a seat reservation in the front. And I dressed Baba regally, like a powerful that, the caliber of the man of God that is going to minister. I know the man when I was in the north, in Kaduna. When they said the man is going, I said, what an opportunity. And listen to me. He was a big man. And they invited me. I said, what a honor to sit in the front row with this great man of God. When I got there, I introduced myself with the invitation card. The best place they kept me was in the crowd among the other people. They say the seat filled. And yet I'm seeing seats in the front reserved. Is that the road reserved? Reserved. And they say, yeah, man of God, yeah, just sit here. See, this is a special ivy. They were doing everything they were doing that quarter. My head was turning. I'm in the wrong place. I'm not here. I'm in the wrong place. No, this is not. This is a shame. This is a disgrace. I was not hearing anything. I hearing. They were quoting to it. I was not hearing Bible. This is not where I'm meant to sit. Those who want to keep you at the back, may God remove you on the journey. I said, may God remove them on your way. The people I met at the gate of that conference, they were bad blood people. Mm-hmm. I guess they have jealousy. A bad blood for me. Mm-hmm. You say, man of God, no, you just, you know, just, you know. Everybody's a man of God. Everybody just, yes. But God! I'm a truth preacher. I was beaten. I was not hearing anything. They were praying, I was not praying. They were opening your Bible, I know they open.
No,
sit here. Let me go. Let me wait until this man start preaching. Let me wait. Maybe I will manage. When he start preaching, maybe after a while I will leave. I was telling myself kind of thing. As if I should just carry stone and beat this people that make me sit at the corner. Suddenly the man was announced. And he was preaching powerfully. I said, let's try to listen, but my mind was not there. I was trying to follow. Suddenly, as he was preaching, moving around, he just moved. He said, Apostle! You don't want to introduce me specially Nicodemusly to my seat. And God make me to be announced by the man that was the center of attraction. When he was dragging me, you know me, I'm a guy. My step changed. My mother-in-law looked at me one day, one Sunday morning as I was coming to church. When she came to visit, as I was crying and I was rashly moving myself, I didn't know she was looking at me from the staircase. Then she looked at her and said, "Hey, pastor, like guy too much." I said, "Mama, you never see anything." The way I walked to my car, I said, "Mama, I'm marketable. Mama, I did comment. Mama, are you old man today? I did camp. Are you hearing me? Don't you say you will not rise. Before their very eyes, you will rise. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus." And it is done. Lift up your hand and begin to thank the Lord.
Oh, Father, I just want to thank you. I appreciate you for what you have done. I thank you for this powerful message.
Thank you for your next level.
Oh, Father, let me preach my blessing and my testimony. In my way, right now, in the mighty name of Jesus. I just appreciate you for what you have done. You are worthy, no Lord. You are the King of Kings. There is no like you. There is nothing we can compare to you. You are worthy. We bless you and we exalt you, Father. I give you all the glory, all the honor, all the adoration of your name. Every knee shall bow. Let every tongue confess that Jesus, you are Lord. Father, we just magnify your name. We just bless your name. I just thank you for what you have done. Thank you, mighty King of Kings. Mighty warrior, great in battle. Jehovah is your name. Thank you, Yahweh. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Ghost, for Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Amen. Thank you, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Yeah. If you believe God has favored you tonight, come and give him a round of applause.
Hallelujah.
Who has the word of God blessed tonight? Yeah.
Come on, shout it out and say amen.
Amen.
Take your seat. Please. I believe you have an offering to give to the Lord tonight. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Going beyond the gate. I'm going to continue that series on Sunday. Going beyond the gate. Are you hearing me? There's a power that can carry a man and carry you to a place with speed where people think you cannot get to. Going beyond the gate. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I want to give an offering to him tonight. The one that is able to carry you. The father of Abraham, Terah, took Abraham on a journey to the promised land, but he didn't get there. He left him at Aram and died. And Abraham lost the purpose of his destiny until God came to him at 75 and said to him, Abraham, Abraham, rise up and I will take you to the place of your destiny. Right at 75, he was left unfulfilled by his father. The father's mission was to take him to the promised land, but the man died at Aram. But God sent him help and took Abraham to the promised land. Somebody hearing me tonight, what your father could not do for you, what your friends have refused to do for you,
yes,
what your boss in your place of work have refused to recommend you, may God of heaven do it for you in the name of Jesus. So family members know what can benefit you, but they have decided not to tell you. I command in the name of the may heaven connect you with your helpers.
Amen.
If your amen is louder, you are receiving a blessing. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And it shall be done for you.
Amen.
This January, your testimony will begin to roll in for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You will look at today's date and remember the Lord for good.
Amen.
And you will bless his name forever.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. The gate of your affliction has been demolished. I say the gate of your demotion has been demolished.
Amen.
The gate of your affliction has been removed.
Amen.
It's your season for the next level.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So shall it be.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Shout the loudest, amen.
Amen.
Begin to speak on that offering tonight and say, Lord, this is my name.